Hello student, from chapter number 4, Laws of Motion. In today's session, we start new article and it is Types of Forces. So basically, in nature, there are four types of the fundamental forces. So namely, gravitational force, electromagnetic force, strong nuclear force and weak nuclear force. But in previous standard, you already learned many types of the forces. Force between two poles of magnet, force between two charges, force of attraction between two objects, frictional force, etc. Many type of the forces you already know. But all the type of the forces are coming under the four basic type of the forces, and it is gravitational, electromagnetic, strong nuclear and weak nuclear. So we have to learn all these four type of the forces in detail. As well as if any force which you know and which is not coming under these four type of the forces, that force is called as pseudo force. Pseudo means imaginary force. Now let's say gravitational force. Now gravitational force. In previous standard, you already learned gravitational force, the phenomena related to the gravity. Now what is gravitational force? It is the mutual force of attraction which exists between any two bodies in the universe is called gravitational force. So you know that between sun and this earth or any other planet, attraction force is there. So that attraction force is a gravitational force. So you know that sun is, means earth is revolving around the sun because of gravitational force. So beyond earth also other planets exist. And attraction force of sun is effective on these planets also. And because of that, the planets revolve around the sun. Means we are not talking about the earth. We are talking about the universe. Between this in universe, the force of attraction between any two objects is the gravitational force. So when we are talking about the smaller object, for example, any object on the surface of Earth, then also the gravitational force is there. So you know that the Newton, scientist Newton introduced the gravity. You know the story of that apple and tree. So we are not going in that much detail about the story, but here, if gravitational force exists between two objects, then how we can calculate the gravitational force? That gravitational force we can calculate by using Newton's law of gravitation, which you already learned in the previous standard. So let's see the formula. So the magnitude of gravitational force exists between any two objects is given by following formula. You can see this formula, F is equal to G M1 M2 divided by R squared. So in this formula, so here M1 and M2, they are the masses of objects. R is the distance between two objects. If I consider this is the first object having mass M1, second object whose mass is M2, and distance of separation between these two objects is R. Then gravitational force directly proportional to the product of masses and inversely proportional to square of this distance. And this capital G is a constant and it is called as universal gravitational constant. So if you know the mass of first object, mass of second object, distance between these two masses, then you can calculate gravitational force. So in this formula, this capital G is 6.67 10 to 10 raised to minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. Or in SI, this is the value of capital G. So it is affixed throughout the universe. Now here, gravitational force is always attraction force. Always attraction. Now it is a long range force. So long range force means we cannot decide up to what distance the gravitational force is effective. So therefore it is called as long range force. So you can imagine that. So the sun and earth, the distance you can imagine a very large distance. Then also the gravitational force of sun is there on the earth. Beyond that distance also other planets, maybe some planet is at larger distance. So beyond that distance also, a gravitational force of sun is there. So we cannot decide up to what distance the gravitational force of sun is there or any object is there. So So here we can say that range is infinity, infinite distance. Now, this gravitational force does not require presence of intervening medium. So intervening medium means medium between two objects. If I consider, so here between these two objects, M1 and M2, air is there. Then the gravitational force we calculate and it is a particular value F I consider. Then between these two, instead of air, if we change the medium, if we use another gas, then also the gravitational force between these two objects remains same. Means gravitational force does not depend on the intervening medium. Okay, and it does not require the presence of medium. In vacuum also, you can see a gravitational force is there. Now, example of the gravitational forces that you already know. Rotation of moon around the earth due to gravitational force. Rotation of planet around the earth due to gravitational force. Attraction force of earth due to gravitational force. You know that earth attracts all the objects. If I leave any object from a certain height, it is attracted towards the earth. The reason is gravitational force. So here, I hope everyone understood what is a gravitational force. So we have to learn a chapter on this gravitational force in 11th standard. So here in this chapter about gravitational force, that's you already learned the same things in the previous standard also. Now we are going for the next type of the forces, and it is electromagnetic force. Now what is electromagnetic force? The attraction or repulsion force exists between any two charged particles. In relative motion, this is very important word, charged particles in relative motion. If the two charged particles are at rest, if I consider here, this is charged particle, charge one, and this is charge two, and distance between two charges is R. They both the charges are rest, then the force between two charges is called as electrostatic force. When these two charges are in relative motion, then only the force of attraction or repulsion is called as electromagnetic force, that you remember. Now here, this electromagnetic force we can write or we can obtain by using Coulomb's law. Now here, just a few minutes ago, we learned the gravitational force. So F is equal to G M1 M2 divided by R square. So this gravitational force and this electromagnetic or electrostatic force, they are analogous. So by using that, instead of charges, means instead of masses, two masses, here two charges are there, Q1 and Q2. Distance is same and constant in electricity is a different, you can see here. So constant I written K, then charge 1 multiplied by charge 2 divided by distance. So same kind of formula you can see. Now here, the value of the K is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon G. So Q1, Q2 divided by R square, we can write like this. So this may be attraction or repulsion. Electromagnetic force may be attraction force or repulsion force. So it is a long range force. So again, we cannot decide up to what distance the electromagnetic force is effective. So it is a long range force. Now it is strong as compared to gravitational. So this force, electromagnetic force, is strong as compared to this gravitational force. The electromagnetic force between two protons, we are talking about a smaller object, two protons. Electromagnetic force between two protons is 10 raised to 36 times the gravitational force. Proton is the object in the universe. Between two protons also, gravitational force is also there. But when we are talking about two protons, both the protons having positive charge. So repulsion force is there between two protons. So when we are comparing the repulsion force between two protons and this gravitational force, then this force is 10 raised to 36 times greater than the gravitational. Now here, examples here, attraction or repulsion force between two, any two charges which are in relative motion, force between two protons. So these are the examples. Now here, one thing you remember. So this gravitational force does not depend on the intervening medium, but electromagnetic force depends on the medium. So between these two charges, if we keep a medium air, then this is a gravitational force by this formula. But if we keep a medium other than air, then the gravitational force is given by this formula, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 k into k1 q2 divided by r. Now here, an extra term k is there. K is a dielectric constant. So you remember here, means this electromagnetic force is a medium dependent force. Medium changes, this force changes. Now I hope everyone understood this electromagnetic force. Now we have to move forward for the next type of the force, and it is strong nuclear force. So in the name, strong word is there. Definitely it is a strong force. The force which explains some microscopic phenomenon such as stable nuclear structure is called as strong nuclear force. So remember one thing here. So stable nuclear structure, you know that inside the nucleus, protons are there. And all the protons are positive charge, having a positive charge. Now you know that between two positive charges, repulsion force is there. Now inside the nucleus, all the protons are there. And if one proton start repelling another proton, then this atom get unstable. But if you see the structure, or if you see the stability of the atom, atom is the most stable. This atom is having a most stable structure. It is a stable. Now, you remember one thing here. So here, strong nuclear force gives us stability. The reason is, so in day-to-day life also, in a particular home, 10 people are living and one people start fighting with another people, then the home is unstable. But in a home, one person is there who can control all this fight. So when that person is present in the home, no one fight. Similar to that, when we are talking about the repulsion between two protons, the force bit of repulsion, then this, as compared to this force, a very large force is acting, which hold all the proton together. And that force is the strong nuclear force. You note one thing here. Strong nuclear force means, which is holding all the proton together. And that force is very, very large as compared to the repulsion force between the two protons. And because of that, it is an atom is a stable. So this force explains stable nuclear structure. Now this force is responsible to hold all the protons in the nucleus. And this force is 100 times electromagnetic force. Means here, when we are talking about electromagnetic force between two protons and strong nuclear force, when we compare, then strong nuclear force is 100 times greater than that electromagnetic force. So here, it does not depend on the charge on nucleus. This strong nuclear force does not depend on the charge on nucleus. It means that how much proton exists in the nucleus, it doesn't matter now. So strong nuclear force does not depend on the charge on nucleus. It is a short range force. Now, the previous two forces are the long range. Long range means we cannot decide the range. But here, this is a nuclear force. You can see the name. Nuclear force means related to or restricted to nucleus. And if you see the radius of the nucleus, it is 10 raised to minus 15 meter. So here, it is restricted to nucleus only. So distance is a short range distance. So this force is called as short range force. Now after that, it is strongest force. It is strongest force among all the type of the forces. Up to this, we learn electromagnetic force, strong means this gravitational force and the strong nuclear force. Then in this, among these three, this is strongest. But if you know the other type of the forces also, among all the type of the forces, this is strongest one, because you can see here the name, strong nuclear. So it is the strongest force. Now, after that, we move forward for the next type of the force, and it is weak nuclear force. Now, you can note one thing here. In a name, weak word is there. In the name, word weak is there. But you remember, this is not the weak force, or it is not the weakest force. So when we are talking about nuclear force, one is the strong nuclear and one is the weak. So this force, so another short range force, this is the weak nuclear force, is a short range force, and it is responsible for such nuclear phenomena such as beta decay. The force which is responsible for beta decay is called as weak nuclear force. We are not going in that much detail about how it is responsible, what is reason behind them. But you remember, the force which is responsible for nuclear forces such as beta decay is the weak nuclear force. The force which is responsible for beta decay, or another, in another way we can write, the force which is responsible for beta decay and which acts between electron and neutron. So these electron and neutron, these are the elementary particles. And the force exists, force which acts between electron and neutron is the weak nuclear force. Now it is restricted to the nucleus, because it is nuclear force. So it is a short range force, range is 10 raised to minus 15. So it is weak. Weak as compared to strong nuclear force and electromagnetic force. But it is quite large as compared to gravitation. But it is not weaker than the gravitation. When we learn the gravitational force, that time we learn it is weakest force. Gravitational is the weakest force in the nature. But here, so this weak nuclear force is not the weakest. It is strong as compared to the gravitation, but weak as compared to this strong nuclear and electromagnetic force. So I hope everyone understood this type of the forces. And you remember one thing here, the force which is not coming under these four basic type of the forces, it is called as zero force. And which is fitted under these four type of the forces is called as real force.